Hi, I'm Valder Beebe, host of the Valder Beebe Show. I am famously known for That Celebrity Interview. Interviews with today's pop icons, movie stars, and celebrities. Tune into our FM radio broadcast and our online broadcast. Visit ValderBeebeShow.com and SoundCloud.com/ValderBeebeShow. I'll see you there. Rebecca Madsen, thank you so very much for talking to us today. I'm so excited that you're here. She's going to be here. Rebecca Madsen here is about the top tips to know when choosing a healthcare plan. Well, it's that time of year. It's kind of chaotic, but it's still that time of year, Rebecca. Can you help my audience?
Yeah, happy to be here today and happy to help people. We know that healthcare can be confusing, and open enrollment is a great time of year to be able to take some time, do your homework to make smart choices for yourself and your family in the coming year.
Well, as the Chief Consumer Officer of United Healthcare, I'm sure that you know the ins and outs. What are we faced with this year like no other year before?
Well, there's always changes in healthcare, and the important thing is making a choice that's right for you and your family. There's a couple things to think about. The first is look at changes. What's changed in your life? Are you sicker? Are you healthier? Make sure that you understand where you and your family are in terms of their health care. And then also look at what's changed in the plans offered to you. People often don't spend the time to do it. They check a box and move forward. But taking the time to understand, are there new plans that are offered? What are the cost of those plans? What are the deductibles? Also look at things like cost. And we know only 9% of people, if you can believe it, understand the four basic terms in healthcare: premium, deductible, copay, and coinsurance. And so taking the time to understand those terms and really get yourself educated will help you make smart choices and not have unforeseen costs. And then lastly, coverage, making sure your doctor is in the network. That's always really important. Two-thirds of people go out of network, and they don't even know that they're doing it.
To make these choices, usually there is a company-wide email, we're going to do this on Friday at 2 o'clock, and you go in this room and you get your little presentation and you make your choices. So do we need to be prepared? Do we need to ask for previous information so we know what we're doing?
It's a great question, and one thing employers can do is they can offer a lot of different channels for people to get the information. You mentioned an email, online tools, also having in-person sessions. Explain what the basic terminology is, what's changed in your plan this year. And then what you can do in terms of doing your homework is there's a lot of online tools now. Look at the claims that you had in the previous year. Understand what costs you had and how to choose a plan that's right for you based on what happened to you in the past year.
I know most of us use cost as the guiding line of what we choose, but what about those hidden things in our plans that we don't know? And a hidden good, I'm going to say that. I found out my plan will provide me with a dietitian. It will provide me with devices like to monitor my blood pressure, but no one ever told me that.
It's a great point, and good for you for figuring those things out in your plan. There's sort of two big categories of things people should look for. One is wellness programs. On average, people can earn $742 a year in a wellness program. 70% of employers offer them. It's a great way to earn money back, but also to stay healthy. So look for those. The second, and you mentioned hidden benefits, a lot of times people overlook dental and vision coverage. And dental coverage is a great way not just to keep your teeth clean and to have good oral health, but a lot of times it's linked to cardiovascular or heart health. And then if you also do other kinds of things like vision, you can get your glasses and contacts, but even if you don't need those, you can see things like diabetes by getting an eye exam. So those hidden benefits usually aren't expensive if they cost you anything at all and are great ways to get added value.
Okay. How do we use our technology tools once again to make this work better for us? Because everybody's got a smartphone, everybody's got a tablet, a desk computer. So how do we make that work for us?
You're right. Everyone's plugged in. We know people check their phone on average 221 times a day. So it's a great opportunity for people to look and use technology to help them. One thing we offer, for example, is a healthcare cost estimator. Many carriers offer similar programs where you can look at the cost and try and predict your cost for the year. That will help you understand, do I take a high deductible plan or a low deductible plan? There's also a lot of other opportunities to look at your claims online. So if you're on the go, you can understand what your costs were. And then once you have your plan, there's wonderful things you can do now, such as virtual visits. You can sit in your house or you can sit on your phone and have a visit with a doctor. So technology is really transforming how we think about healthcare.
All right. And one more question. This
Sure.
is coming from Facebook. They want to know that we hear about... Oh, thank you for saying that. We hear about these advances on the Valder Beebe show, such as 3D mammography and other things. How do we find those in our plans?
There's been a lot of advances in technology to help people both understand where they are in terms of healthcare, but also when they're actually getting their visits. 3D mammography is a great example. So look at your plan and the plans you're choosing and see, are those services covered? Also talk to your doctor. We know the doctor is the trusted source of information, and really understand what's available to you. They often know what's covered in your plan, and that's the best way to make sure that you're educated about what the latest in technology offers, and also make sure it's covered so you don't have surprise out-of-pocket costs.
Rebecca Madsen, thank you so much for making my morning, just starting my morning off great for my audience. These are the questions. This is why I get to do the show, because I want things that's going to help people change their life, and these will change our lives. So thank you for being my guest. Where can my audience go online and find out more information?
Well, it's my pleasure to have been here today and talk to your listeners. There's a lot of sources. One we have is uhc.com/healthcareabcs, and there's lots of helpful information, tips. It's available to anyone, and we hope that it helps make the open enrollment process easier for people.
Rebecca Madsen, Chief Consumer Officer of United Healthcare. Thank you, Rebecca.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.